artist, the criminal, the stereotypical hard-working Mexican immigrant. They think they have an audience. Kraftwerk just peeps me, a guy pushing ants from his laptop, cut and paste mishmash wrapped in an enormous ego, an ugly personality. It's meaningless chat of terrible footage, anti-performance or something like that. All of hip-hop? Not music, that. Move away from latent plagiarism. Picasso was never called an asshole. John Coltrane? Just noise. Eat, shit, sleep, repeat. Retro, rehash, repeat, revive, revise. My Bloody Valentine? Where are the tunes? Black power, symbolism, and salute. There has been no sanction at all. I don't believe the writer. Why didn't he stay with many of his fellow countrymen? Looking like a Somali, I would be concerned if I wasn't stopped and questioned. It's happened to a Muslim friend of mine who also travels a lot in his line of work. Telecoms. I get calls where a number is displayed, but when I call back, it's disconnected. I suggest getting rid of the beard. Look at the consistency of the people who have blown up planes, trains, buses, and cars. Many blonde, scanty types. I'll take that as sarcasm. Ever heard of Breivik? As a blonde, totally Caucasian, heterosexual female with a fairly British name and a partner of similar ethnicity, I have never, ever been hassled by police. I have strolled through airports in a cloud of weed stink and got away a wink from a security guard. They let me take a book of matches onto the plane because they were from a famous nightclub. On any rational calculus, I'm more at risk from bad drivers than terrorists. Never trusted them anyway. The founder stole the algorithm from his friend, stole the idea from the Winklevoss twins, connived his associate out of shares, the list goes on. Acted like the old class of robber barons and land tyrants of the last century, was supposed to represent a new breed of entrepreneur, that of the internet guru or Gujarati, the smartest of a new generation that had it with the old ways. Pipe dreams. They've got lots of new pipes around these days to invoke believable dreams. Shock in art works best when it's incidental, because the casually racist murders and sex and death in Sigatoga is shocking until you realize the way we treat animals will also come as a shock one day when humans are incredibly good at fooling themselves, which art that does not conform to acceptable maximize profit from appealing to the widest. Censorship has become a financial. Would American Psycho forget Islam? The true threat to Western liberal democracy is pictures have made Fight Club. Somehow it still even shocks, but shock would naturally continue. Unlike now. Some commentators, a lot of people learn, realized them is conformity. Will kill each other for? Domination by big business instrument and lowest common denominator, commercial vectors means shock is inevitable. We're reduced to the animal in the equation. The main character fits all too perfectly Australia's racist history. Apparently, when art sets out to shock and is shocking to people, the status quo itself is shocking. I'm just relieved I finally found something that rhymes with orange. Only if you're French. Blorange, the Welsh mountain, is another matter. Having never heard her name spoken aloud, I've been calling her Solange in my head. There's a wider conversation, though, about the extent to which society values its artists. As it has always been, the people who are getting rich are not black musicians. If Prince had been born 30 years earlier, he would have been a bebopper. This is the Beatles becoming essentially a studio band after 1966. People need to write the code, design the systems, etc. Why should musicians, authors, etc. earn vast sums of money? All e-commerce innovation happens in the porn industry. Why should anyone get paid if cavemen didn't? Why pay the plumber at all? Does Prince get paid if I flush the toilet? This comment is very lightweight. Even though I like panpipes and also glockenspiels, I didn't have the patience to carefully read it. I used to think that talent was the magic formula, and either you had it or you didn't. In about 91, a dude at uni showed me his computer, which was connected to computers all over the world. Blue screen with white text on it. He was breathless with excitement. I shrugged, failed to see the point or possibility, and went for lunch.